Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the fingerprints of Dajjal is one eye. Which we all understand in the light of a hadith, Dajjal hasn't got an eye in the middle of his head. He got two eyes. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke about one eye. This one eye from the beginning of time, you will trace it. Wherever people went far from Allah, you will always find one eye featured. If a person goes to Egypt and he goes to see the mummies of that time, the pharaohs, which has been taken out from the pyramids. When those pyramids, if you go inside and you see what was taken out in that time, where the pharaoh was put, you will see one eye. The one eye featured in the time of the pharaohs from before, showing that this shaitan was in that era already. Moving throughout the time, what and what evil he did, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala alone knows. For which reason Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, every Nabi warned his ummah, watch out for the shaitan called Dajjal. And his efforts infiltrated throughout every religion which broke up the religion. You will find him breaking up the religion of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, although he was already locked up. But as Tamim Dari radiallahu anhu saw that he was still speaking in his time, we will find that he is what we call modus operandi, way of method, which went throughout time how to break through religion, continued right through. Where you will ask people who are called Buddhists, who is Buddha? They will say, Buddha is the one eye, the enlightened eye, the eye of wisdom, that is Buddha. That man who God came into. And then he started teaching the people. Fir'aun said, Ana Rabbukum al-A'la, as though I am God. Nabi Isa alayhi salatu wasalam was lifted. Paul came and he told the people, let's forget Isa alayhi salam. The Isa alayhi salam that we worship is a man in whom God came. And the entire Christian religion was broken. The Shias, when they came out worshipping the Imams, they said, leave the Anbiya on their side. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam came to explain man the religion. But the Imams, who were they? They were a people in whom God transcended. And it was God now speaking his religion. He became an Imam, a Ma'soom. Able to change the Sharia because God was speaking to him. All of them spoke about one person in whom God was calling. In the time of Sulaiman alayhi salam, he was locked up, and how long he remained locked up after that, but he continued spreading fitna in the world, because of which we find his alamat all over. However, in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, an amazing thing happened, which he told the ummah, in my time he is coming out. And then he said he is being born. And then he went and he said, this is the person. And then Umar radiallahu anhu said, let me kill him. He said, if you kill him and he's not the person, what's the need? Which left a question, that, oh Allah's messenger, don't you know whether he is the Dajjal or not? And then when Ibn Sayyad said, if I'm given the job, I will take it. He was talking of one job which all of this indicates towards and which happened in the past. Is that this shaitan for him to move in the world is not like a normal shaitan who moves. But this shaitan who we know as the Dajjal, he needs a body to carry him in the world in the guise of man. What throughout history, every batil religion called hulul, where God is coming into a certain person. Whoever believed in hulul was believing in the Dajjal, the shaitan coming into a person, and from now on we worship this person. And that is who. When the Christians speak about Isa alayhi salam, they are worshipping the shaitan who came into a person, and they are saying this is God. And every shaitan wished that I should be God. When the Buddhists speak about the enlightened eye, Buddha, they are speaking about the Dajjal. When the Shia speak about our hidden Imam, Al-Imamul Muntazir, the one we are waiting for, Muntazir, the Imam who got lost and is alive for so many years, they are speaking about this one Imam. Ulama has written that when the last Imam of the Shias went into hiding, one person who saw him gave a description. That description fits the description of Ibn Sayyad. The Shias are waiting for one Imam who is called Dajjal. The Christians are waiting for Isa alayhi salam, or they're worshipping Isa alayhi salam as God, they are worshipping a Dajjal. The Buddhists are worshipping a Dajjal. Whoever believed in hulul is believing in the shaitan that came into a man and went out in the world as Dajjal. And Rasulullah